So I was doing my traditional one-on-one coaching, and I loved it. In fact, what actually happened was I had set up a blockchain facility for fun. And when I set it up, I had rented a warehouse along with a large number of people, and we were putting cryptocurrency miners in there and GPUs in there and a whole bunch of other cool technology, and we were having fun. And one of the people that actually owned the warehouse that we ran said, "Oh my God, like the interns, the students you brought with you are amazing." He says, "My son is going to graduate college in a year with a computer engineering degree. What should he study? What should he learn? I want to be like yours." I said to my friend, I said, "Look, I'll do this. I'll train your son. He could be one of my students." I said, "You're a friend." I said, "We set up a blockchain data center and you've never even charged me rent." I said, "So I am going to personally coach your son." I said, "Here's what we're going to do." I said, "I'm going to buy him the top three best-selling certification courses." And I researched the top three best-selling ones and I bought all three. I said to my friend that I'll spend 2 to 4 hours with him every Friday after my yoga and physical therapy is done. And my friend was so thankful. Now, something interesting happened. The person I was mentoring called me back after 3 days and he said, "Mike, I set up an AWS EC2 instance and an AWS S3 bucket, and that was easy, but what are they?" I said, "What do you mean, what are they?" And he said, "What is S3? And what is EC2? I watched his courses. Now, these were big name courses, and let me tell you, when I watched them, I was horrified. The course was the name of a service and how to configure it, but it didn't tell you what any of it was. And I said, "What good is knowing the name of a service and how to configure it unless you want to be a junior administrator, where basically all you do is click, click, click? Nobody could ever get hired with that skill." And I went, "Oh my God, who would produce content like this?" I was horrified. So the first thing that I actually did was this. I said to this nice young man, I said, "You and I are going to write a book on passing the AWS Certified Solution Architect Professional." He said, "We are?" I said, "Well, there's nothing out there and you need to pass this exam. So we're going to toss all that stuff and we're going to create our own." And he says, "Okay." And I said, "Guess what else we're going to do? As soon as that book's published, we're going to give it away for free, because all these people that are charging for this horrible nonsense are taking people's money and they're giving them hope, but they'll never get hired. So let's give them this free book and hand it out to the world." Well, we handed out so many of those free books fast, like 25,000 in a matter of a couple of weeks. So we did that and I was feeling a little better, and I made a couple of YouTube videos on how to get your first cloud architect job. And whoa, within 24 hours, I had so many emails. "Could you do this? Could you create a program? Could you teach it?" And I said, "If there's this much desire, and I know what's out there, somebody has to save these people that have invested the last year of their life doing these certifications, because they're never going to be hireable." So what I did is I did a webinar one day where I talked about how to get your first job, and I couldn't even finish the webinar. People were signing up. I want this, Mike. Create a program. So what did I do? I took orders on that call and I said, "Within 2 weeks, we're going to start the program." So I had, set up the first 2 weeks of the training. People were in, people are signing up. We created the program and our students were getting hired. And it was really exciting because, I always wanted to create a program that I could give to anybody in the world that was basically as close to free as possible. And what we did is, I took this $40,000 or $50,000 training program and packaged it to be sub $1,000, because I knew that, an average cloud architect earns about $600 a day, and a good one with good leadership training can earn $1,200, even $1,800 with experience and capabilities. And I wanted to produce somebody that could take those senior roles, but I wanted to do it at a price that anybody in the world could afford. And we did it. Now we have about 800 students. Every day somebody's getting hired. This morning one of my students is getting hired. Yesterday one of my students is getting hired. And it's literally speaking, it's every day of the week. So we're super, super excited. So, that's why I went from one-on-one coaching to this. I saw what was out there. And there was nothing that was going to produce results. Nothing that could get anybody hired. And I felt bad for the people that had spent all this time. I tried to watch these courses and it was just sheer torture. PowerPoint slides with voiceover on all irrelevant and mostly incorrect content. It was just terrible. So I did what we did. We're excited what we did, and now we've got an army of people that are getting hired out there. And some of the proudest moments of my life, when every time somebody calls and says cloud hired, it brings me to tears. So it's been an exciting transition. Our programs are unique in their focus. See, 90% of the community is focused on certification. Let me just get you that certification badge. But here's the thing. Certification is nice in that it will get somebody to interview you. But no one cares if you're certified if they can hire you. They care about the following. They care about, are you technically competent? They care about, can they trust you? They care about if you're a team player. They care about your emotional intelligence. They're looking for your energy, your enthusiasm, your passion. They're looking for your communication skills. They're looking for your ability to go above and beyond and bring out the best in others. See, that's what employers are looking for. So we focus on what employers are looking for, creating that real competency, which is different than certifications. It's kind of like the difference between what we do in college and what we do in the job. The college is very valuable. Well, the job is not necessarily what we learned in college, but college gave us the foundation, maybe taught us how to learn. And in the job, we use those things that we learned, and then we learn 10 times more. So it's kind of like that. But really, the key for me is, what good is paper if it doesn't get you hired? So our focus is 100% on hired, hired, hired. But our focus isn't just on hired. Our focus is on career optimization. See, here's the thing. Individuals with greater levels of soft skills typically earn 30% more. Statistically speaking, emotional intelligence is the best predictor of one's long-term success. So in our content, we're focusing on those things that employers really desire. The things that make you stand out in the crowd or someone stand out. The things that make employers say, I need to hire you. So I studied interview tactics and trends for 25 years. And I started studying this because I had no choice. I was in medicine and I had to convince people to hire a network engineer that had 0 degrees in tech or 0 background in tech. And I did a good job of it. But I had to learn some special skills along the way. And I learned how to wow a hiring manager and how to interview. So we teach that. And I also learned that those that could negotiate a higher salary earned more. And you know what? That can have a long-term impact on your career and your future job. So we added a salary negotiation module because it was there. We teach the interview skills because we're there. We're teaching leadership skills. We're teaching emotional intelligence. We're teaching presentation skills, business acumen. And here's why. When it comes to an interview, 50% of the person's interview in the tech world is about how technically competent they are. But the other 50% is everything else. And when you've got someone that's brand new and you want to get them a really great job and not an intro level job, they've got to be technically competent enough, but you can't get perfection out of somebody without 25 or 30 years experience. We've got to get them good enough. But the secret sauce, the secret weapon to success is that leadership skills, communication skills, executive presence, emotional intelligence, the things that make you so much more likable to the employer. So if 50% of your score is technical competency, you can get to 40 out of 50 on someone with good training, and you can get to 50 out of 50 on the other thing, the candidate's average score is a 90. Well, I've interviewed 5,000 people. Getting anyone that's past a 65% is great and hard to do in tech. So if you can get 50% of it just by getting all those other things that no one else trains, those expensive things to train, and only do the tech, you're not halfway there. So we do both. We do all the factors because it's a holistic system. Look, you know, people form relationships based upon lots of things, and players hire people based upon lots of characteristics. So we teach all the characteristics that employers desire. And here's the thing. Not only are we planning the season getting somebody hired faster, but it all goes back to the tenets my manager said to me 20 years ago. He said, Mike, the difference between a $150,000 engineer and a $300,000 architect who's really more of an executive is executive presence, communication skills, leadership skills, business acumen, presentation skills. So I teach all of those. And by doing that, our people get hired. Our graduates get paid a lot. My graduates on average get paid between $100,000 and $300,000 a year based upon, you know, whether they're brand new or not. But here's the key, we're getting that. Now those higher salaries are impossible without soft skills, emotional intelligence, and leadership skills. So we teach it all. And that way our students have the best outcomes now And 2 years from now, 5 years from now, and even 10 years from now, they have all the tools for success. Really, the thing is, why did I work so hard to make it low cost? It's for a couple of reasons. I remember in the beginning of my career, I had to work 60 hours a week to go to college. And I did it, but it took a toll on me. And I've had a lot of mental toughness training, special physical training, special martial arts training, and a lot of mental toughness training. So I survived it, but it took a toll on me. And I remember I wanted to advance and I did an MBA, or I took, you know, half of an MBA program, and literally speaking, it was like $50,000. And in the end, I didn't even finish the MBA program because I got a job offer that was so good I couldn't refuse it, which had nothing to do with the MBA program at all. But so I ended up stopping the MBA and getting that great job. And in that great job, I started tutoring people. And I started tutoring people of very limited means, and they started rising to the occasions. But I also started tutoring the people that I worked with, and they were also there. But, you know, for me, it was that. But really, I feel like I don't need to work. I'm very thankful for that case. I had a really great career. And when I look around and I look at what education is today, it is just so expensive. You can get out of the school with $200,000 of loans and still not even have a job. And I have so many people that came to me that have spent so much money. They're doing master's degrees in cloud computing and are not hireable because they're learning the wrong skills. They're getting expensive certification courses. I have people that have spent $25,000 on a data science boot camp. I have a student that spent $35,000 on a CompTIA Security Plus certification. I felt so bad that we found a way to help him and help him get hired. But the point is, you know, there's so many people that are out there. And I know what it's like to come from limited means. It's hard, and I don't want anyone to ever not be able to get to the career of their dreams because they can't afford the training. You know, I had dreams, and everybody has dreams, and I love dreams. Dreams are where innovation comes from. Dreams are where great things are made. Dreams are how the world changes. But you've got to be able to get to your dreams. So for me, it's really important to make it available. And I have friends that laugh at me. They say, Mike, your course is worth over $50,000. Look at the salaries of your graduate. Look at this. And I say, yes, but do you know the number of people that I helped get a job last year that would have never been able to afford this training? Do you know how many people that went from poverty to prosperity this year? And that's what makes me happy. That's why I do this. And that's why we charge what most people would consider to be a ridiculous price for our program. But you know what? Anybody that really wants to have our program, anybody that wants to train, anybody that wants to become a cloud architect can afford our programs. And because of that, we are not a financial burden on someone. I don't want to be the program that when somebody's done and they get their great job, they have to pay $30,000 back. I have people offering me that. Hey, I'll pay you extra when we're done. And I say, no, I don't want that. I want to build your life. I want to change your life. I want to enhance your life. I don't want to be a burden. And that's the thing. You know, I spent a fortune on education. I have $250,000 education. And, you know, I was lucky that, you know, my employers paid for some of it. And I got lucky that I had a great job to be able to do that. But not everybody can. And I want everyone that wants to work, that wants to be a cloud architect or a cloud engineer to be able to, and that's why I do what I do, because I love my tech career, and I don't want anyone, regardless of their economic situation, to not be in a position to have the career of their dreams. So that's why I do what I do. You know, I expected to create a program that was going to get people hired, and it did. But I was just thinking it would be more transactional. People would come in, they'd train, they'd be grateful, they'd be hired. And that was what I was planning. And, you know, that would have been great. But what I got was so much more. We had been around for a little while, and I had students that were just incredible. It was like a family. And actually, two of my students in the beginning of my program met with me in Florida. And they said, Mike, you know, what's going to happen when you have 10 times a student? And I kind of laughed and said, yeah, that's not going to happen. And, you know, a month later, we did. And they had set up a communications platform called Slack. You know, for me, I'm like a phone person. I call people, I text message, and I email, and I don't use anything else. But they were saying we can use the Slack thing and people will talk to each other. And I didn't believe it, but I said, prove it to me. If I can get create a family, if I can get our students working together, interacting together and being better, I'm in. So they did. Well, I hired one of those people and he helped me run the company. And because it worked out so well and our students are doing so well, which I love, but really the community element. I mean, one of my students get hired, they bring three of their friends. Somebody gets a job and their friends help them in their beginning architectures to make sure they're secure. Somebody's ready to pass an exam and they all go and tutor the person for a week. It's like the greatest thing ever. And I see my students and talk. The students, literally speaking, we have a group of 50 people that are volunteering right now, people in Africa, to learn cloud computing, and we're doing it completely free. And that's something my students are doing. My students have written a book, which we've given out free to help people in cloud computing. So, you know, we're going to be writing another book really soon that we're going to give away completely free. We're doing an AWS boot camp next week, completely free. And people from all over the world, they're like, oh my God, we're here and they're learning. And you know what? The people that take our paid programs always get hired. But you know what? The people that are watching on this on YouTube, some of them get hired too. And they send us messages that said, hey, wait, we read your books. We came to all your free things. We watched every video you did, every LinkedIn thing. And guess what? I got my first job. Thank you. So really, it's how fast is it proliferated around the globe. How many people are getting hired each day? How many people are getting promoted each day? How many people have helped each other get to their goals? We had last weekend, we had people getting together in Dallas and New York and Atlanta. And we've got a group getting together in England, another one in India. So, you know, we've got our students together and it's such a magical family. And I couldn't be more happy, more proud, and more excited to realize this is where we've gotten to.